Welcome to another episode of The Christian Heart. Wonderful stories about people showing their love for Jesus by loving and serving others. This is the 14th installation of our podcast, which is a ministry of thechristianheart.com. All these stories can be found on our website, and every 2 weeks, we pick another 4 stories to share with you on this podcast. The stories themselves come from all over the country. In fact, from across the globe, the stories are inspiring, often emotional, and always true, which makes the telling of them very special. This is not fantasy or promotion. It's real life, featuring real people, not characters in a drama. Today, our story lineup begins with a nurse in a neonatal ICU unit who wanted to find a way to help grieving parents that had lost a child at birth, and how she started sewing ministry. Yes, a sewing ministry, to make sure those heaven-bound babies are lovingly cared for, even in death. Here's our first story today, Angels in Waiting.
I have been a neonatal ICU nurse since 2010. I am also on the bereavement committee, and part of my job includes dressing babies once they pass on to heaven. God has been speaking to me about finding someone to help sew gowns small enough to fit our premature patients, and in turn, assist grieving families through the bereavement process. As always, God has already paved the way. At a small group meeting through our church, I met a new friend. She had delivered a baby boy in 1985 who was only on this earth for a few hours, then delivered beautiful twin girls who were born sleeping in 1993. God had also placed it on her heart to help other grieving mothers. After meeting at small group and through several conversations and confirmations, we both decided to say yes to the Lord, and Angels in Waiting 91:4 was birthed. The Lord gave us Psalm 91:4 as a reminder that He will and does cover us with His wings, and under His wings, we find refuge. We wanted to share this verse with the families for them to hold on to during their time of grieving. Angels in Waiting 91:4 takes donated wedding dresses and transforms them into beautiful angel gowns for an infant's journey to meet our Lord and Savior. Several ladies have now joined us on our mission. Though they initially thought they were only there to sew, they have encountered Jesus in mighty ways, and many hearts have been transformed. We meet every Tuesday to transform donated wedding dresses into gowns. We begin with a worship song, prayer, and devotion. Once we complete the gowns, we pray over and anoint each one. They are then wrapped individually in cellophane, placed inside a beautiful box that includes 25 gowns, 5 crocheted hats and booties, 3 crocheted blankets, 2 angel wraps, and 1 keepsake envelope. Along with each gown, we include a card that reads Psalm 91:4 on one side and "Too Beautiful for Earth" on the other. The boxes are delivered to hospitals across the country and recently even to Canada and Israel.
Next, a solo act, a ministry with one volunteer who decided she could do better at helping the street corner homeless people in her city. It's been 5 years since she started making and handing out her Love on the Go bags. But oh, what a difference to the person at an intersection asking for enough change to get his next meal. Here's an inside look at the ministry that produces Love on the Go bags.
I started putting these Love on the Go bags together about 5 years ago. I got inspired while driving and constantly being stopped at certain street corners where homeless people ask for money or help. I'd scrounge in my car to try to find anything to give them, a water bottle, a power bar, or some spare change. But one day, I felt a nudge from the Holy Spirit to do more. After praying about this, I decided to put together ready-to-go bags with loving messages, hygiene products, first aid kits, socks, food, and water. Now, I'm never empty-handed when passing or driving by someone hungry or in need. Jesus said it best in Matthew 5:42, "Give to the one who asks you, and do not turn away from the one who wants to borrow from you." In a small way, I'm trying to live up to His word.
It's an old expression, but so true. One thing leads to another. Start with a simple speech, but make it emotionally charged and inspirational. Add in a motivated church volunteer, now at a ministry created specifically to help adults with developmental disabilities. And watch for reflections of God's glory right here on earth in the faces of those receiving help. We hope you enjoy this story, helping those created for His glory.
It's intriguing how the Lord will use one person or event to just change the course of our lives. A year and a half ago, I heard Johnny Erickson Tada speak at church. And after listening to her, my daughter and I volunteered as camp counselors at the Johnny and Friends family retreat. And I was so moved that I now volunteer in our church's ministry that serves people and families who are touched by disability. But I also learned about a ministry called Unless You, which serves adults with developmental disabilities and their families through continuing education and by promoting life skills, social skills, and independence. The Lord led me to begin volunteering at Unless You in June, and I love it. I help students with various activities such as reading, writing, math, social skills. Each week, I am blessed by the amazing students at Unless You. Through them, I have learned so much about God because I see His image reflected in these students. As I work with them, I continue to see His compassion, kindness, and mercy in the way they treat one another and others. Their beautiful, simple faith has taught me much about my own lack of faith. All in all, I have the privilege to see a glimpse of God's glory displayed in the hearts, attitudes, and interactions of my friends at Unless You, and it is beautiful to see.
And finally, on this 14th episode of The Christian Heart, when do you do your best listening? Most would say, usually when it's quiet and there are no distractions. So what if the quiet is because you're on a hospital bed, alone, and worried about your future? And what if the absence of your distraction is because you're recovering from serious, life-changing surgery? It might not be a surprise to find your hearing has indeed improved. And you might also realize that you're hearing a very special voice. Here's the story we call Hearing God's Quiet Voice.
I was an electrician for the first part of my career, but in 2000, I injured my back and had to undergo major surgery. The surgeon told me I would need to find a new line of work. You have a lot of time to think when you're laying in a hospital bed, and I started praying about what God wanted me to do now that I had to make a career change. It's amazing how you can hear God when you're quiet. He spoke to me, saying I needed to minister to people in hospitals. There was a guy in the bed next to me, a painter, that didn't know the Lord, so I thought I should get started. I began sharing what he had done in my life, and wouldn't you know it, he accepted Jesus into his heart. As soon as I got out of the hospital, I met with the pastor of our small church. He encouraged me to move to a church where there was a need for such a ministry. My wife and I searched for a new church, and there again, the Lord showed his hand. The minister said they needed help with pastoral care, so I started making hospital visits. I loved it, but little did I know that the hospital visits were just preparing me for something bigger. I felt the Lord was nudging me to minister to people in nursing homes. That next Sunday, while I was helping in the church parking lot, a member started talking to me about his relative in a local nursing home and how they wanted a Sunday service. I went there and asked the director if I could come to see the residents a couple of times a month and share some biblical truths with them. I was welcomed, and for the past 11 years, I've preached to them twice a month. It's been a blessing to me, and it never would have happened if I didn't take the time to listen to his quiet voice. When I look back at how everything unfolded for me after my accident, I can sure see God's hand along the way.
That's a wrap on another episode of our bi-weekly podcast series, From the Christian Heart. If you like our encouraging podcast, please subscribe on Apple Podcasts, Google Play, Spotify, or Stitcher. And never miss an episode. If you know of an inspiring story, perhaps even your own, we'd like to hear it. Just go to www.thechristianheart.com. Click the button at the top of the page that says, Suggest a Person, and let us do the rest. The Christian Heart blog contains 250 other encouraging stories, and these can also be found on our ministry's Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram platforms. Either way, be sure to look for and listen to another episode of The Christian Heart, coming in just a couple of weeks. Thanks for joining us.